In our video number 4, we will be looking at one of IDA's essential tools, the navigation band. When you run IDA, one of the first things you will notice is this colorful navigation stripe. It is also called a navigator or navbar. This is a very convenient and powerful tool, as it displays the address space of a loaded file in a linear view and allows you to see at a glance how well the program has been analyzed and what areas may need attention. You can scroll through the entire address range of the file. The different colors of the band represent different types of content. For example, the cyan, turquoise color indicates library functions, functions that have been recognized by a flirt signature. Usually, such library functions come from the compiler or third-party libraries and not the code written by the programmer, so they can often be ignored as a known quantity. The blue color shows regular functions, for example, functions not recognized by Flirt or Lumina. These functions could contain the custom functionality specific to the program. To learn more about Lumina, click on the link in the description below. The brown color refers to instructions, code, not belonging to any functions. These could appear when IDA did not detect or misdetected function boundaries, or hinted code obfuscation being employed, which could prevent proper function creation. The gray color represents data. It is used for all defined data items, string literals, arrays, or individual variables. The olive color is for unexplored bytes, for example, areas not yet converted to either code or data. Magenta is used to mark functions, or data dynamically imported from other modules at runtime, including wrapper thunks for imported functions. Lime green represents functions recognized by the Lumina server, the public or a private one. They could be either library functions or custom functions seen previously in other binaries and uploaded by users to the Lumina server. These colors can be changed. Simply go to Options, Colors, select Navigation Band, and then choose an element and click on Change Color. And confirm your selection. The changes will be displayed immediately below. If you're not happy with the result, click Reset, otherwise confirm. Now, let's look at the tiny yellow arrow in the navbar. It shows the current cursor position in the disassembly, IDA view window. When you load the file, you will spot a small orange triangle opposite the cursor moving along the band. It shows the current auto-analysis location. Once the auto-analysis is completed, it will disappear. On the right side of the navigation band, you will notice a drop-down list menu called Additional Display. It allows you to add some additional markers to the band. We will not go into details about the different displays. Instead, you could read more in the links in the description below. Next, we are going to talk about making some additional configurations to the navbar. If you would like to hide the band, go to View, Toolbars, Navigator. To show it back, follow the reverse order. Often, when reversing, you'll be using more than one monitor. In this case, moving around windows and sections will come in handy. You can resize the navbar or detach it using the drag handle. If you prefer, you can position it vertically or keep it horizontal. If you keep the horizontal view, it might be interesting for you to know that you can show or hide the legend and the additional display drop-down menu. By default, the navbar displays the whole program, but often you would need to zoom in or out at a specific part. Right-click on the navbar opens a context menu from which you can zoom in or out. Below, you could also select zoom and then you'll need to choose from several alternatives. The numerical options specify how many bytes of the program are represented by one pixel on the band. Another possibility is to position your mouse's cursor on a segment. Press the Ctrl key and move the mouse wheel. When you're happy with the layout, use arrow buttons at either end of the bands to scroll through the code. It is also possible to scroll by using the mouse wheel. When clicking on a specific part of the band, it will reflect on the disassembly view. You can also obtain hints about a specific location in the navband if you leave the mouse over it. We hope that you enjoyed this video. Show us how we did it below and don't forget to keep following our channel for more helpful content.